Was the Fed too slow to recognize inflation in 2021?
So in hindsight, it would have been better to have tightened policy earlier. We thought that the economy was so dynamic that it would fix itself fairly quickly. And we thought that inflation would go away fairly quickly without an intervention by us. And so in the fourth quarter of 21, it became clear that inflation was not transitory in the sense that I mentioned.
Fed Chair Powell's recent warning about the economy has sent ripples through the financial world, raising the Atlantis report concerns about the sustainability of the current economic conditions. Powell's cautious stance reflects the uncertainties and challenges the economy faces, and it's essential to look into the factors contributing to this unease. It is also important to examine some of the key points and implications of Powell's warnings and why they matter for the future of the U.S. and the world. Powell's remarks come amidst unprecedented challenges facing the global economy. The warning, delivered during a speech at the Economic Club of New York, highlighted the fragility of the current economic situation, stressing concerns that the ongoing conditions may not be sustainable. Powell emphasized the need for a cautious approach to monetary policy in his address, citing persistent challenges facing the economy. He pointed to several key factors contributing to the unstable state of affairs, including inflationary pressures, labor market dynamics, and geopolitical uncertainties. These issues, Powell noted, pose significant risks to the stability and growth prospects of the economy. One of the primary concerns raised by Powell is the persistence of inflationary pressures. Despite initial hopes that inflationary spikes would be transitory, recent data suggests otherwise. Inflationary trends have proven more stubborn than anticipated, fueled by supply chain disruptions, labor shortages, and robust consumer demand. This persistent inflationary environment has prompted fears of sustained price increases, eroding purchasing power, and potentially dampening consumer belief. Moreover, Powell highlighted challenges within the labor market, noting that while significant progress has been made in reducing unemployment rates, structural issues persist. He pointed to disparities in labor force participation, wage stagnation in certain sectors, and ongoing challenges related to workforce reintegration following the disruptions caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. These labor market dynamics pose challenges for economic recovery and have broader implications for income inequality and social cohesion. Geopolitical uncertainties also dominate the economic horizon, adding another layer of complexity to an already challenging landscape. Powell cited geopolitical tensions, trade disputes, and the evolving global economic order as factors contributing to uncertainty and volatility in financial markets. These uncertainties impact investor confidence and have implications for international trade, investment flows, and global economic stability. In light of these challenges, Powell emphasized the importance of a careful and flexible approach to monetary policy. He emphasized the Federal Reserve's commitment to closely monitoring economic developments and adjusting policy measures to support sustained economic growth, price stability, and maximum employment. Powell's remarks suggest that while the economy has made significant strides in recent years, significant challenges remain, requiring careful navigation and proactive policy responses. The financial markets reacted swiftly to Powell's warning, with heightened volatility and fluctuations observed across asset classes. Investors and market participants are closely monitoring developments, seeking clarity on the Federal Reserve's policy trajectory and assessing the potential implications for investment strategies and portfolio positioning. JP Morgan immediately warned about mortgage issues. The call to sell now is based on a reversal of their previous recommendation to buy 5-year treasuries. This change of heart was fueled not just by Powell's remarks, but also by regional banking concerns and data signaling. With JP Morgan forecasting an upside surprise for January payrolls, the timing suggests a strategic move for investors to sell bonds now. Despite the modest drop after the report, JP Morgan remains optimistic about the medium-term outlook for treasuries, expecting yields to rise in the coming weeks. Goldman Sachs presents a contrasting view, suggesting that the pain trade is now lower, not higher. As investors flock to U.S. equities, specifically the magnificent 7-inch stocks driving the market higher, Goldman warns of all-time high problems for the U.S. equity market. The top 10 companies now represent 33% of the S&P 500, an unprecedented level of concentration. This concentration is risky, especially with machines heavily loaded on long positions. The potential for a market downturn becomes more significant as extreme machine positions often precede substantial selling. machine positioning in the market becomes a focal point, with CTAs, risk parity, and volatility control funds showing signs of being overly long. Goldman emphasizes the market's vulnerability to downside moves when machines are poised to sell. The top-heavy nature of the market, with a few dominant players, amplifies the risk. The prevalence of algorithmic trading and machine-driven decisions highlights the need for investors to be aware of these dynamics. Analyzing the charts, the S&P and NASDAQ momentum remains positive, but caution is advised as the RSI approaches overbought territory. The S&P's all-time highs and the NASDAQ's upward trajectory raise questions about when a reversal might occur. Setting and raising stop-loss levels is important to navigate potential downturns. The warnings from Fed Chair Powell, JP Morgan, and Goldman Sachs collectively paint a picture of an economy facing challenges. The delicate balance between optimistic economic indicators and underlying vulnerabilities requires investors to stay vigilant. As machine-driven trading plays a significant role, understanding their positions and reacting reasonably becomes crucial in navigating the uncertainties ahead. Powell's warning comes at a time when markets are up and down and economic signals are unclear. Stressing the importance of grasping market trends, Powell pointed out how markets are changing and urged the use of smart investment approaches, which include: Powell's warning prompts a closer examination of global economic trends, with a particular focus on China's evolving market landscape. While some investors continue to chase higher returns in the U.S. equity market, Powell's remarks highlight the potential for significant opportunities in identifying undervalued assets. Powell's insights resonate with the fundamental principles of investment, identifying deep value options with significant growth potential. Investors can navigate volatile market conditions and capitalize on emerging opportunities by recognizing market signals and exercising prudence in investment decisions. These opportunities cannot be capitalized on without analyzing market indicators such as the Relative Strength Index, RSI, and Moving Average Convergence Divergence, MACD, which provide valuable insights into market sentiment and potential trends. Powell's remarks highlight the importance of understanding technical indicators and leveraging them to inform investment decisions. Powell's emphasis on downside tolerance underscores the importance of implementing effective risk management strategies. By setting appropriate stop-loss levels and managing downside risks, investors can mitigate potential losses and optimize investment outcomes. Powell's warning serves as a timely reminder of the interconnectedness of global markets and the potential implications of economic trends. As investors navigate uncertain economic waters, Powell's insights provide valuable guidance in assessing market dynamics and identifying investment opportunities. Every word from the Federal Reserve Chair holds immense weight in the fast-paced world of finance and economics. So when Jerome Powell issued a stark warning about the state of the economy, it sent ripples through markets and sparked conversations among analysts and investors alike. Powell's message was clear: the current trajectory is unsustainable, and urgent action is needed to steer the economy back on course. The background against which Powell's warning grew was one of volatility and uncertainty. Market indices fluctuated, with traders anxiously watching for signals to guide their next moves. Powell's words injected a new layer of complexity into an already intricate world of economic indicators and market dynamics. At the heart of Powell's warning was the recognition of several troubling trends. Economic growth, once robust, was showing signs of failing. Key metrics such as GDP growth and employment figures painted a picture of an economy struggling to find footing. Moreover, inflationary pressures were beginning to rear their head, raising concerns about the purchasing power of consumers and the stability of financial markets. Powell highlighted the need for decisive action to address these challenges in his address. He emphasized the importance of fiscal and monetary policy coordination, calling for targeted interventions to support economic recovery. Powell acknowledged that the pandemic required the federal government to spend aggressively to avoid a deeper recession and to support the millions of Americans who lost their jobs and incomes. However, he also stressed that the exceptional period is over, and it is time to return to a more prudent and responsible fiscal policy. Powell admitted that the U.S. economy is still a long way from the Fed's goals of maximum employment and price stability, and that it will take some time to achieve them. Powell also said that the recovery has been highly unequal, as the pandemic has hit some sectors and groups harder than others. Powell's remarks highlighted the delicate balance that policymakers must strike between stimulating growth and managing inflationary risks. To understand the gravity of Powell's warning, it's essential to examine the context surrounding his remarks. Analysts pointed to a mixture of factors contributing to the nation's economic troubles. Supply chain disruptions, worsened by the ongoing pandemic, were exerting downward pressure on productivity and output. At the same time, labor market dynamics were evolving, with structural shifts leading to mismatches between job seekers and available positions. But these issues lent great significance to Powell's warning. It was a call to action for policymakers, urging them to confront the underlying issues driving economic instability. The urgency of Powell's message was not lost on market participants, who reacted swiftly to recalibrate their investment strategies in light of the Fed chair's remarks. As analysts looked through Powell's words, they sought clues about the Fed's future policy stance. Would interest rates be raised to curb inflationary pressures, or would the central bank opt for a more accommodative approach to support economic growth? The answers to these questions would have far-reaching implications for investors, shaping their expectations and investment decisions in the weeks and months ahead. Following Powell's warning, economists and policymakers engaged in a spirited debate about the appropriate course of action. Some advocated for aggressive measures to reignite economic growth, while others warned about overheating and inflation risks. The ensuing discourse reflected the complexity of the challenges facing the economy and underscored the need for nuanced policy responses. Looking ahead, the legacy of Powell's warning would resonate through the halls of power and the trading floors of Wall Street. It served as a wake-up call for policymakers and investors alike, reminding them of the fragility of the economic recovery and the imperative of proactive intervention. In the coming months, all eyes would remain fixed on the Fed, awaiting signals about the path forward and the measures that would be taken to navigate the turbulent waters ahead. Powell's warning serves as a sobering reminder of the fragility of the current economic environment and the importance of vigilance and level-headedness in navigating the challenges ahead. As policymakers, investors, and stakeholders grapple with these complexities, the need for a coordinated and forward-looking approach to economic management becomes increasingly apparent. In the face of uncertainty, adaptability, resilience, and proactive decision-making will be key to steering the economy towards sustainable growth and stability.